Ankit Vora. Raise your hands. Raghav Sharma. Yes, Raghav.
Good morning, sir.
Anji. Rishit, can you tell me which one of the following terms are not associated with the first stage of planning? First stage of planning. For example, first, option A. Option A is assessment. Sorry. For option A is the surveying. Option B is the assessment of resources. Option C is the available technology, and option D, none. Option D, none.
Sir, option B.
Option
B.
B. B option was? Kya option bataya aapko?
Assessment.
Assessment. Assessment part nahi hai. Assessment is a part to which we can assess what type of the resources are available. Inventory identification means what type of resources, where they are located, and which form of resources are available. I'm repeating again, the identification and inventory, that stage of a resource planning, it has associated with the surveying, with mapping and assessment of a quality and a quantity of resources. As first stage, the second stage of a resource planning, second stage of resource planning is associated with the assessment of demand in market and importance in economy and availability of a technology are associated with the second stage of planning. Third stage is the planning of resources, means utilization of resources in such of the way through which the present needs of resources, it can be as a complete as well as the future needs. We have to save the resources for the future also. We have to save resources for future also. So the resources, as we know, so option none. So resources, as we know, they are the unevenly distributed over the earth. Unevenly distributed both in terms of their types and their quantity. Their types, quantity and the quality has varied in all over the world. For example, Rajasthan and Gujarat, these two places are known for the generation of a very good wind and solar energy. The tropical conditions of Rajasthan and Gujarat are favorable for generation of solar and wind energy. But there are also possibilities to develop as tourism. Which is not equivalent in other areas, but except them, when we are moving towards the northeastern states of India, which are rich in a forest resource. So resources are the unevenly distributed. So for their uneven distribution, we have to need as a resource planning. That's why the resource planning needed. Why do we need the resource planning? Because resources are unevenly distributed over the earth. Second, most number of resources are exhaustible in nature or conventional in nature. Yes, Harshita, can you tell me what it means, conventional sources? Harshita,
yes,
what it means, the conventional sources of energy?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me what it means, the conventional sources of energy, with example? Conventional sources of energy.
The non-renewable resources are known as conventional resources. These are the sources that cannot be renewed.
Okay. Conventional means such category of resources used by the humans from age old historical background. These are conventional. Half of your answer is correct. Conventional sources are also known as non-renewable resources. They are known as a non-renewable, but the word meaning, the meaning of a conventional means the resources, the category of a resource is used by the humans from old historical background, from age-old traditions when humans used such resources to satisfy their needs. Example, firewood. Example, coal. Then natural gas. Then petroleum. ये सारे conventional है क्यों? ये आज से नहीं पिछले 1,000, 2,000, 5,000 साल से humans started their use of such resources. Those resources, their development begin in a recent in time around 500, 400 to the 500 years back. These are non-conventional in nature. जो recently start हुए हैं. For example, geothermal energy, wind energy, water energy, clear tidal energy, nuclear energy. These are the examples of a non-conventional sources of energy, which are also known as a non-conventional are known as a renewable resources. Renewable resources. Clear? So the uneven distribution of a conventional sources of energy, conventional sources of energy needs as a resource planning. Question was asked, why do we need as a resource planning? Because resources are unevenly distributed over the earth. Second, as most number of resources are conventional in nature. Conventional, they are limited in number. Resources are limited in number. Limited in number. Resources are limited in number. So most number of resources are pollutes the environment. It leads the environmental degradation. That's why their planning is desirable. Planning also required for the regularize the level of development, sustainable development. Resource planning is a desirable for regularize the level of development in a present economy. In present economy. Clear? Depending on the types of the resources available in areas, government should try to develop it. Develop it the such resources which are available in abundance. Those resources which are present in abundance in an economy or in a country, these are utilized by the government to complete their needs of energy. To complete their needs of energy as their optimum utilization. For example, in India, water resource, the hydropower stations, where the rotation of a turbine has occurred due to the flowing water, through which electricity has generates. Electricity is generated through this system. Raghav Sharma, raise your hand. Raghav Sharma, okay, leave it. No. Yes. So some other examples. Yes, Mehul. Your plan. What was the tenure of time period of first 5-year plan?
Sir, first 5-year plan.
Yes, bachche. Till the time 12 5-year plans initiated by Government of India.
Sir, what? I don't remember.
Okay. This has marked in your chapter. First 5-year plan. Harshit Sani.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Harshit, 4 options are there. 1947 to 52,
1951 to 56, 1956 to 61, and E option none. 1951 to 1956.
They can work for the improvements in the nature, means they can solve the problem of unemployment and poverty in their country. Problem of unemployment, poverty, conservation of resources, and protection of environment from a further depletion. Means control of global warming. As we read the USA, it is as a developed country, but this is also the leading producer of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, due to which as a ozone gas depleted in Antarctica. Ozone gas depleted. Ozone, its molecular formula is O3, which has depleted with the excessive use of CFCs. CFC stands for chlorofluorocarbons, which are emitted through the refrigerators and air conditioners and refrigerators. Clear? So we can, with the conservation, we can conserve the resources in a different ways. For example, judicious and a proper use and management of resources, with judicious planned and proper use of resources. Second, through which we can conserve the resources, minimize the wastage of resources at the time of extraction, production and processing. Processing, when we are transformed the resource into the usable items, and afterwards use at the time of extraction, when we extract in a process of a mining, when we process in an industries, and third, when we start to use them at the T stages, when we reduce as their wastage, through which we can conserve the resources for the future generations. Use of our cyclic resources, those resources which are present in an abundance in our nature, in our environment, and which are recyclable in nature. For example, iron, it can be as a recycle by the humans, and same as the solar energy, wind energy, water energy, which are renewed by the nature, recycled by the nature. Clear? Next, to develop as a substitute for the use of resources. For example, India is a leading producer of bauxite. Bauxite is an ore of metals, non-metals, Pradya, science. Yes, you can easily answer. Bauxite is an ore of iron, steel, silver, gold, platinum, tin, copper, aluminium, brass, kiska. Brass is an alloy, steel is alloy, yes. Iron, then iron ore kiska hai? Wo bhi iron ka. Yes, online students, Gur Simar Jyot, raise your hand. Gur Simar Jyot. India is a leading producer of a bauxite in world market. Gur Simar Jyot. It proved that he is not sitting nearer the phone. He is unmuted but still not answering. Yes, Mehul Bajaj.
Yes, sir. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Yes, bauxite.
Aluminium.
Aluminium. Can you tell me what it means, alloy? Sorry, ore.
Yes, sir.
Ore means what? What it means, ore? What is an ore?
Sir, log.
Ore means block. So that is our resources. It can be as possible with the reckless and inappropriate exploitation of resources. Exploitation of resources in country. So we have to regularly check upon the unusual exploitation of resources which are generally found in a country, to which we can reduce their usage and conserve the resources for the future. Recycling and treating the waste materials. Proper treatment of the waste materials which is available within a country, to which we can conserve the resources. Because with the use of our waste materials, we can utilize in a constructive way. For example, the domestic wastewater, it can utilize for the irrigation purposes. Irrigation purposes. In Punjab, one of the social activists, it has working for it. It has utilizing, it has emphasizing over the conservation of the water resources. What is the name of that particular social activist? Social activist which worked for the cleaning of a Kali Bay in Sultanpur Lodi. That water body which has associated with the first Sikh Guru, Guru Nanak Dev Ji. So what is the name of that social activist in Punjab which worked for the environment protection? Environment protection. Raghav Sharma again left. Yes. Very good, Bhavin Malhotra. This is as the Sant Balbir Singh Sichewal. Sant Balbir Singh Sichewal. It is known for their environment conservation works in a parts of a Tarn Taran and Goindwal. Tarn Taran and Goindwal. Tarn Taran and Goindwal. This was as related with the conservation. Now the next topic as a land use pattern. Land utilization. Land utilization. When land has used for a different purposes, it's known as land utilization. Land utilization has depend upon the different number of the factors. First, very good. First is the relief. Land is generally used on the basis of a relief. Mountains, plains, and plateaus. All over the world, the 43% of the area covered under the plains, 30% of a land has covered under the plains, again plains. Yes, 30% of a land area has covered under the mountains, 27 under the plateaus. Plains are known for the habitation sites. Plateaus are known for the mineral deposits. And mountains are known for the biodiversity. They are rich in our plants and animals. They are rich in our biodiversity. So land utilization has affected by the geological structures. Relief. First, second, environmental conditions, climatic conditions. Different types of climatic conditions means temperature and rainfall. They are influencing the land use pattern. Where the more rain has occurred in such areas, people are more practicing as agriculture comparatively to other areas, northeastern states of India. Due to the availability of rain, availability of water make possibilities of production of crops. So climatic conditions are influencing the land use pattern. Third, soils. The different types of soils which are preferably used for a production of crops are either the less fertile soils, it can be utilized for a location of industries. Location of industries. So these factors are influencing as a land use pattern in India. The land use pattern has generally categorized under the five categories. First, arable land. Arable land means that land which is capable for a production. Cultivable land. It has divided into two parts, net sown area and a gross sown area. Net sown area and gross sown area. Net sown area and gross sown area. Net sown area is a that land, that kind of a land which has used, generally used for a production. Used for a production in a year is a net sown area. Same area when it has utilized more than once in a year for a production is known as gross sown area. Clear? Arable land. Total land which has comes under the cultivation is a net sown area. Total land which has used more than once in a year for a production means three agriculture seasons which has used for a production is known as gross sown area. First. Second category of a land use pattern is a second category. Very good. Forest lands. Forest lands. Generally, forests, there are three categories of the forests are there, which are generally used for a growth of a economy or a society or an environment. First, reserved forests, those forests which are comes under the afforestation. Earlier as a depleted, but through the afforestation, the area under the forest cover has increasing. It has increasing. Second as a protected land where the forest, these are depleted due to the cutting of trees. Such trees are cut due to the shifting cultivation, construction of dams, growth of means of transport. So the forest earlier as a depleted, but now through the afforestation, the area has increasing and these are further protected from the depletion. Third are the unclassed forest. Those forests which are growing basically to complete the needs of a wood of society. To complete the need of wood in society are known as the unclassed forest. Third category, third land use pattern is a very good fallow land. When land remains unused for a certain period of time to regain their natural fertility is known as a fallow land. Next week we will continue.